Hi everyone, it's Monica with Scrap Saturdays. It's Sunday. I always like saying that, it's funny to me. So yesterday, my sister-in-law Marlene, hi Marlene, had an awesome Scrap Saturday at her house. In Portuguese, it was Dia das Amigas, which is Day of Your Friends or Your Girlfriend's Day. And instead of going to the party, because most of us have dietary restrictions, and you know, when you go to a party like that, you're going to get a set meal and whatnot. So we decided, or she did, she offered us her food at her home. My mother-in-law graciously cooked for us all day long. Thank you, Sganalda. We made it a Scrap Saturday. And usually we kind of host these or have these at our houses. So my other sister-in-law, Maria, I don't know if she watches my videos, but I'm going to say hi, Maria. She'll host it. I'll host it. I haven't hosted one this year because I've been lazy. I don't know. It's not lazy because I hate packing. Oh my God, packing for a crop or a Scrap Saturday, as we call it. Yeah, it has to be the worst thing, right? You try to pack lightly, there's just no way, right? So backtracking, yes, it's going to be a long video. Grab a drink, grab a snack, I'm not sure. This is a layout share, but it's also an exciting little thing that I learned how to do and I want to talk about it. So I figured I'd just sneak this in for today and then next week it's back to the boring process videos. Okay, yeah, so consider this a treat. And I even cleaned off my desk, see? There's nothing here. Magically, it's all over there and you can't see anything. But, okay, yeah, so Marlene hosted a Scrap Saturday, and usually we do it up until summertime because then we don't really want to sacrifice our beautiful, you know, summer Saturdays where we can be outside and still get together as a family but not be stuck indoors, right? So I don't know if I'm going to have a chance to sneak in a Scrap Saturday at my house before April comes around and then it's Easter time and all that other good stuff, right? So yesterday I did 1, 4, 6, 7 layouts. So that's not bad, right? 7 layouts. I went to yoga in the morning. So by the time I got there and kind of, you know, settled in, it was already lunchtime. And then we stopped and had lunch. So that's not bad. And then we scrapbooked until about 11 o'clock at night. I did go to Michael's and purchased some of their Valentine's that they had for 60% off. And one of the things that I did was I made kits for the girls as their treats yesterday. And one of our challenges was to win an extra stamp set that I had brought with me, was that they had to use all of their stuff. And so I kind of used some recollection stuff that I picked up yesterday at Michael's. And this is their 8.5 by 11 Valentine's paper pad. This is the cardstock that comes with it, and then this is a photo that I took from my daughter's phone. Thank goodness for kids' phones and being able to steal photos, because they take the best selfies, don't they? I think they do. I think it's fun. So this is a Forever 21 clothing tag that I saved, but I just love the gold detail in it. This is also from the Recollections. It's a wood veneer button. And then this is those flowers that I've like exhausted. Like every single layout I'm going to show you has something you've seen before. And then I just use some washi tape to frame it around. It's very hard for me to work with themed paper. I'm going to say that it was funny that I gave the girls this challenge, but if I can be sincerely honest, it's hard for me to do it. I really find it, I struggle with it somehow. So this was my first one. The thing that I wanted to talk to you about today with the rest of my layouts that I'm going to share to you is I wish that I can, or that I could have remembered, but I was literally YouTube surfing, as I call it, where I spy on what everybody else and who everybody else is watching, and I just, you know, lazy Saturday night, maybe on my couch, and you stumble across people's YouTube channels. And sometimes I don't subscribe because the rest of the content that they have isn't something that I would watch. But some people have like these one-off, like, I don't know if this has ever happened to you guys, but everything else on their channel, you know, I don't, you know, maybe I don't understand it, different language or something, or it's content that I sincerely have no interest in, right? I'm going to be honest with you. But then they have like these one random one-off, you know, scrapbooking things, and I think that this is what this was, but I can't remember, and I apologize, but if I stumble across it, believe me, I will be writing it down on a banner and putting it on the side of a wall, because this woman deserves the credit for something that I played with yesterday the whole day and feel like as if, you know, oh, I found this miracle cure for something. So, basically, and I will grab my explanation. So, we all have packaging, right? And I know that you cannot see, well, you can see it now, right? The packaging that I'm twisting here. This packaging with the slits on it is left over from my Aero paper clips that I use. So it's like This American Craft stuff. So you see the little slit here, right? That comes. And so this is the packaging that's left over. Usually I throw these away. And basically I have some cut up pieces from packaging that's like this. So packaging that, you know, that kind of packaging where letters come in and then you've got that cardstock on the back. So we've all had packaging like this, not just in scrapbooking world, but in everyday life world in general, right? So basically what this person on her YouTube video did, and if you've watched her and you know who she is, go right ahead and write her name down on the comments or whatnot. She put her title, as you see when I lift this Boo Bear title, on this piece of acetate and then just tucked it here. And I was like, what? Yeah, let's try this again. She put her title on this acetate piece and put it where she wanted to. Yeah. What? Exactly. So literally I was like dozy watching this video. Huh? Maybe I had watched like 16 of them trying to get my mojo back. Should I go make a video? Blah, blah, blah. All those things. And when I saw this, I literally was awakened to this epiphany of what? That is incredible. I need to do it because that is one of the things I personally struggled with and could not identify. Yes, I know. Makes no sense, but it will in a minute. So usually when you try to do your titles, right, you can't put this Boo Bear title on top of like 16 layers of paper, 4 embellishments. Look, as I ruined the A. Right? It will look like this, right? It's not going to sit straight on your title. But when you put it on acetate, ta-da, it looks straight and you can't see it and it doesn't block your layers and it doesn't take away from the color and it actually, you can put it on here and then move it around. Oh my God, there's so many amazing, amazing uses for this. Regardless if you end up liking this or not, I mean, I am like wanting everyone to try this because it's just, I don't know. You'll see my other layouts and you'll see. Now, here, you can see the glue line, right? You can see my hot glue blob. Why? Because I had glued this tag in so tight that I couldn't squish this in further. But, you know, practice makes perfect, and that's what I was doing yesterday. There's no shame in trying something new and then perfecting it. Yep, so that's layout number one. Layout number two is landscape, right? Yes. Awesome. So I tried two things. One, I used my sister-in-law Marlene's Stays On ink. Thank you, Marlene. And I stamped this awesome Michael's stamp from their Valentine's Day. I think this was a dollar, literally. Like, hallelujah, we never have anything for a dollar in Canada. And look how awesome. It was like it was made for me. I absolutely love the word love written like this because I love it with a little heart at the bottom. Hello, that's exactly what I do on the top of my eye on my name, Monica. Anyhow, yeah, I told you it was a rambling video, but you'd like it. It is awesome. Awesome. It's going to stay like this forever because I'm never going to stop using it because I freaking love this stamp. So yeah, I used it with the Stays On ink and it dried really nicely. And then these are really old thickers. I don't know the names of them, anything that I used. I'm really sorry. But this E is a hack job E. Now, for this capture, it isn't loose, right? So I can't flip it up for you. I actually glued underneath the C and I mounted this wood grain piece onto a foam dot so that I could bring this into a flatter surface. I hope that makes sense because from this height to this height, it kind of drooped and then there was too much bounciness to it. So I didn't like it. So freaking love this layout. Isn't it awesome? So many little pieces. Now, remember, when I go to these scrapbooking or scrap Saturdays at people's houses, I honestly try to just use whatever I have and just go with the flow, because when you're talking and you're distracted and you're not in your home environment and you're not in your desk, it's almost like when you're away on vacation and you're not sleeping in your bed. Unless you can sleep anywhere, then, you know, this analogy isn't for you. You kind of feel out of place. So I just kind of tell myself, go for it, Monica. Just ding, 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 put things down. And this one, I played around with a lot of the movement, but I used, like, this piece was supposed to be with this piece of cork. But cork doesn't seem to be my friend, and so it kind of had broken apart. So I hid the broken part underneath there. This is from an old, I know that home collection paper. I can't think of the name. This is a Project Life kit that I think my sister-in-law gave us, but I really love the quality and the texture of this. So I used quite a few pieces like that yesterday. So I like to use the gifts that we do get generally as a treat for ourselves. And then this is just literally leftover scrap-tastic paper. I was indecisive about this yellow bow, so I kind of was like in and out and in and out, but then it settled there and it's so cute. And I haven't used buttons in a while, and I thought, you know what, green circles would do well. And this is a photo of me and my snuggle bear, my son Augustino. And it's, I believe it's, I think it's a selfie we took in the summertime. I don't even remember where or how, but I just love it. I think it's so cute. One of my little homemade tags, you know, my wood veneer people. This is a Heidi Swap little noted tag that I made, and then some more curly. I'm really liking the thread curl thing. Kind of got back into that too. Of course, there's some delicious Heidi Shine gold mist. Yeah, that's what it looks like. I mean, that stuff's insane. It just, like, it's the earrings to the outfit, man. It's just awesome, awesome, awesome. Yeah, layout number two. Flip it over to, I know. Yes. Please tell me this isn't the most amazing idea since sliced bread. Look at this. I know. I can hear you. You're running to your desk. You're running into your recycling bins as we speak, and you are taking out all of the packaging. Now, granted, I didn't say that the only negative up close, like on camera, I don't know if you can see it, but you will see some scratches. It's not like the perfect piece or the most immaculate piece of acetate, and I get that. But honestly, for the amount of times I've said this before, that you're going to look at your layouts, the perfect that you're looking for is good enough, right? Let's be honest. So here I actually made a fishtail. Can you see that? Yeah, you can, right? With the glare, you can see that. I fishtailed this piece of acetate. Now it's very sharp, yes. And then I glued it underneath the C, I think. I think the glue is here somewhere underneath the letters. I try to. And I use hot glue. That's what I do. I totally use hot glue. This is, again, that same awesome thick cardstock. I believe it was a Project Life, Becky Higgins. I don't know. And this tag matches it. So it's the same color. A leftover sticker from Pink Fresh Studio, I believe, and it's been like in my stash for a long time. And I'm sorry, there's so much glare. Is that better? Is it darker? And then these are my homemade flowers that I made. And this is what I was trying. Well, my next video for Saturday, you'll see, I'll talk about how I used gold embossing. So this is a Tim Holtz gold embossing powder just to do it. And then this one, of course, is the double layered stamping. Right? But the bottom one, this is just gold embossing and then the smushing technique, right? And then some white, I don't know what it's called, dilutions paint, yes. Those wooden, these wooden veneer pieces are from Recollections that I had purchased yesterday. And then the background is just awesome and I love it. And that's a photo of me and my hubby. I don't know where we were going. Date night? No, grocery store? We're probably just going to the grocery store, okay? I won't even romanticize it for you. And the funny thing is that my front door is teal, mint, turquoise, whatever you want to call it. Of course it is, because I need to know where I live, because nobody else's door is teal. And it matches my hoodie that I'm wearing, because why would I wear any other color other than teal? Because it's my favorite color. But I actually used a filter on this one because I'm going to have to do a video on my Canon selfie. Oh my gosh, I love that printer. It is an awesome photo printer. Like, I don't know. I'm in heaven now. I'm just like perfect, perfect, perfect. I love it. I just have to find some more apps to tweak the sizing because so far the only thing I've perfected is the Instagram size. I don't know how to do smaller yet. So I'm still working on it, but I love it. And so this is some sort of filter on something. This is still that leftover Webster's Pages piece of paper that has all the goodness in it. And I think, you know, when we used to do those tag videos and people used to ask you, like, what is your favorite piece of paper or what is your favorite collection ever? It's got to be that piece of paper. That piece of paper literally brings my essence to life. I love it. So I do have some left over. I know you're thinking, oh my God, more layouts of the same thing, but I wanted to show you just how awesome these turned out. And so it's just using Heidi Shine. So there's that, I don't know what color this one is, the primrose, and then the teal and the mint and the white dilutions. But I think that these turned out awesome. And then the smaller flowers, it's like this is a Prima chalk ink. The underneath one is a Heidi Swap pink, and then there's some Prima yellow or goldy type one, and this is another chalk ink. And I love the way it looked out. Fussy cutting isn't my forte. I did use some distressing, Tim Holtz distress ink, which I haven't done in a long time, but it did help to buffer out my fussy cutting because without the distress ink, I think you can notice on these when I say that you can see the distressing on the edges. It takes away, see, you can see that there. It takes away the whiteness or my imperfection of what I don't like about fussy cutting. Now, I know that I see flowers all over the place and it's all the rage. That's what I think. I'm going to be honest with you. But I'm seriously in love with not making them. Making them is a little bit tedious. Like I put on Netflix and I kind of go and do my thing. Excuse me. But I love using them in my projects. And I really love that it's original. Like it's an original thing. So there's another landscape style layout that I absolutely freaking love. So this is layout number 3. All right. So moving along, I was like, okay, so now I have to do something different because I keep doing the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over, right? Yeah. So this one, I again stole this photo from my daughter because she seems to take the most amazing selfies of herself, which very good. I encourage her to do so. And it was about her little bun and her glasses and, you know, she's 13 and I just thought, it's just awesome. I just had to take this one. So the circles were in a different piece of patterned paper. It was on a 12 by 12 piece of patterned paper. And I cut them out with my We Are Memory, Creative Memories circle cutters, which I don't have the exact size. That's why a lot of them have the leftover pieces because I couldn't exactly find a way to do it. And then I stole Mercy Tierra or Tracy's, you know, outline it with a marker or with a fine liner thing because I've seen her do it. And then I just kind of glued, you know, bits and bobs here. So it's really not my style of layout, but I like it for the whimsicalness that it is for what it is, right? It's just a layout like I just showed you makes me more giddy. This one, I almost second guess myself because it's not my style. And I hope that makes sense. Like, I think it looks good. I think I did a good job. I think I mimicked a lot of, you know, ones that I've seen before, but anyhow, you know what I'm trying to say, right? So this bottom piece is another, I think it's part of a treat that we got as well. And it's from those Instagram or Instax type project life kits that you get at Michael's in a box. So I use that as the background because one of these circles that I cut out says the blah, blah, blah. And I really wanted to use it, but it was at the edge of the page. So I had to use a green circle to kind of fake it out. You know what I mean? And then I put a captured tag there just to hide it. The U is on, yep, you guessed it, a flap, right? So now it sits on top of her, but it doesn't have to ruin her photo. It doesn't leave glops of glue. It's lined up here so I could play with You know what I mean? It's Sunday. We stayed up until I came home 1 o'clock in the morning from scrapbooking. Are you crazy? That's so much fun. You're lucky I'm awake today. Some more recollections, some enamel dots from recollections as well. Really old stars from, I have no idea. You probably remember these. They came with a blue one and these ones as well. And then some Heidi swap. And then I used Becky Higgins Project Life stamp, and I put one on this side, and then I mimicked and used a different one on that side. And then again with my marker or my fine liner, I just kind of did some squiggle lines. It's all freehand. I know, I'm talented like that sometimes. Yes, I am. Anyhow, I loved it. Loved it. The papers that I layered with, this is DIY shop from Crepe Paper, I believe. Again, my 6x6 pads are the easiest things to carry when I go to a crop like that. So this is layout number 4. Flip it over to, I wanted to save this for last because this is my absolutely, yeah, it's my favorite layout. Like, honest to God, I created this and I was like, whoa. And I know it sounds, and I'm a very humble person, but you gotta get credit when you, you know, sometimes nail it. And I totally, like this one, I was like, Monica, you did good. Like, I just love it. I love everything about it. Okay, so another stolen photograph. I don't know how my daughter edited this. But she gave herself green eyes. She has actually very beautiful blue eyes, but it's so funky and it's so poignant knowing that she loves to, you know, read so many crazy, amazing novels. And I just found it to be very funky and different. And in the black and white, it's just, she's awesome. She has a scar on her eyebrow. My son threw a plastic toy, a sharp, broken plastic toy at her head. Yes, yes, my kids are normal, just like your kids. He didn't mean to. It was by accident. This is what they told me. I mean, this is a long time ago, but her eyebrow has never grown back on that point, but she actually embraces it. I mean, until now she has. I don't know when she's older if that changes. I hope not, but you know, you can always cover it up with makeup, but she doesn't obsess over it, and it's totally become her signature, and it's just awesome. Okay, where do I start? Yeah, totally. I did glue this one down completely, but if you can see, it is another one of those fish banner. Yes, can you see it? Yeah. And at first, yeah, no, I did all the layering. So this is always the last thing that I put down. And you can see my finger moving right underneath it. So I glued it underneath this so you wouldn't see. And I glued underneath the W. So that would be the thickest point. This is another one of those tags. And I'm telling you, this quality is amazing. I backed it with this piece of paper, which I know this is all from the open book from Maggie Holmes, but this piece of paper I think is not. I think it's still from the other one that I was using, which I can't think of it right now. So, and then this is another piece of acetate from that same acetate that I showed you on the other one that has the fish tail. And my daughter reads 500 books a week. So this book spine piece of paper from the 6x6 pad from the open book was like perfect. And at first I had sort of like tried to make a frame of books, like, you know, but then it didn't work that way. And honestly, this is one of those times where I love that these inspirations come to me during Scrap Saturday and that I'm making the most of my time when I pack up all my stuff and it's so much work to go and unpack and get yourself comfortable. But I so wish that this was one of those videos I had recorded as a process video only for you to see what it takes to come to this end result. But literally when I'm in the zone doing something like this, I am like completely transformed. I am in my most creative element, and these kinds of layouts or this style of layout versus what I just showed you with the circle, which is fine, right? I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it, but oh, How silly, it's on this side. I was trying to find it. Anyway, when you look at something like this, like I did this, but it's just, I'm like, eh, there's something missing. But when I look at this, I'm like, there you are. Do you know what I mean? So I put the word you up here right now. So this is what I had done with my, and I'm going to try and grab it for you to see if I've got any leftover in here. So you can see what I'm talking about. Aha. So what I did with the remainder of my letters, because I usually have like a hodgepodge of leftover letters, right? That spell nothing but burr and nothing, right? So on this side of my packaging, so the actual packaging, I took as many letters as I could write stuff with. And like this T is not really a T. It's like an upside down L or something. And then I cut up other letters and I create the letters that I need to create. Like this T is also an upside down L, but until I told you that, you didn't know that, right? And I try to, like, this is not really a Y. Now that you can see it, it's like a K. But again, you know, for the amount of times that people are going to look at it, they have no idea. So if we don't tell them, they don't know. And the people that are going to watch my videos are not going to come look at my albums, right? So I create these words, right? You know, capture, memories, whatever I could spell, you know, at that point. And again, like, you know, this is an F, not an E, but you wouldn't know that. And then it just makes my titles easier. They come faster. So that was one of the tips and tricks that I think I've mentioned in a past video where I've really tried to take my leftover letters and take some time while I'm watching Netflix to create words or something, because I could have put love you with another, you know, chipboard letters or something like that. And so right now, believe it or not, was one of the words that I had there. And then the breathe, you know, it may not make that much sense, but it looks good, I think. I think it makes sense. And then I use the brackets because I just loved their curliness. There is a lot of mixed media, as I'm going to say in my next layout video for next Saturday. I feel sad because there's so much goodness underneath these pages, as you can see my pop dots and stuff like that. And I wish there was a way to, you know, express them or capture it more, but I did try to bring that goodness towards, you know, the corners and stuff like that. But I love it. Here's some more of that Webster's pages leftover pieces. If you could really see up close how it looks like there's like little mice bitten notches out of it, is because it was such a small little piece of paper, but I didn't want to throw it away because the color combination was so on point with what I wanted to do, and I just wanted to add something extra there. And I literally used my Martha Stewart leaf punch just to punch it out. And then of course I tried to purposely put the points of my flowers, you know, pointing out as much as I could to create all that dimension. And look at the goodness of what mists and embossing can do to transform, like finding your stamps and just transforming them into your own homemade embellishments. Like, it just makes me so, so giddy. So yeah, this is my favorite layout. Mm-hmm. Moment of silence. I know. So what's this? Layout number 5. All right. So then after I created that, I was like, I have nothing left. I felt like I had, like, you know, totally poured my soul out. You didn't see that, but it came from my heart. You hear that from here. So then I had this piece of paper. I don't know who made it, but I had some leftover of that other open book papers. And we had gone bowling. This is a very current photo. This is like during Christmas break, January maybe, first week of January. We actually took off our pajamas and put on civilian clothes and went to the bowling alley. Yes, we did. And this is another, I don't know if you can see it if I tilt it, but I made it a complete banner. So it's fishtailed here and fishtailed here. And then I used the word amazing and I glued it along the top of the Z underneath the M and just put it there. And then again, it just sits nicely there, but it's still see-through so you can see everything else. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? I know you're loving that idea. You see that? You see that? It's just so freaking awesome. I love doing it. It is like my new addiction. So, little pieces, little bits and bobs. This was another cutout or a piece of paper that was from the open book collection. And I don't have any like tiny word stickers. I never had a package of those at all. And I don't think I've ever looked at Michael's to see if they have the Tim Holtz ones. I should, but I don't. And I love that look. So I just kind of mimicked it. I really liked the pattern of this paper, the direction of it, and the colors completely match the colors of the bowling alley that we went to. So that's kind of where I get my, you know, groove and how I get to this result. So if that's what you're wondering, I purposely, you know, cut this paper and put all these things so that I could work this way, right? So I start off with the photo matches, the paper is good. You know, we continue on. I add the layers that I like, my little homemade pieces of this and that, leftover asterisks from the same thicker set. I added in a new wood veneer from the package that I bought yesterday. Same with this. This is all from the Valentine's Day wood veneer package from Recollections. And then lots of, you know, paint splatters, because white paint splatters look amazing on dark toned paper. And yeah, this one was pretty easy. It came together really easy. But again, I still give it as much credit as it deserves because I think it looks awesome. That's me and my fam jam. They're so cute. And then banners that I had cut out a long time ago, but the colors weren't right. Oh, hang on. This is layout number 6. Yay! I feel like you're going to call in and vote for which one you think is your favorite. Okay, last one. I'm almost done, I promise. Hopefully you still have a little bit of drink left and a little bit of your snack left, because how long have I been yapping for? Half an hour. I warned you. Now, last one of the night. This is like 11:15. I've got the other side of the paper that I had to piece together to create this look, right? Because this piece, you see here, it's cut. But when I do 8.5 by 11 with, you know, my manufacturing strip, I always have to do some sort of like, you know, embellishment to get the other side to somehow work with what I have left over. Now, I'm going to say that these are Heidi Swap stars. If they're not, then someone can correct me, but I have had this package in my stash for 350 years, and I've been using them here and there and here and there and here and there, and yesterday I'm like, they're all going, right? That's right. So I did have navy blue thickers, and yeah, look at that. Ta-da! I know. Isn't it great? I love it. So with my navy blue stickers, and you see, I cut out the acetate so that it would accommodate my lowercase y, so that my lowercase y isn't flopping. I'm telling you, I freaking love this idea. So let's see. I used every single star left in the package, and this is early morning, just before I go to work, and my uniform for work is navy blue, and I think my husband's sweater, his uniform for work is navy blue too. So that kind of just worked with it, and I really liked the navy blue pieces of paper and just the color tones of everything. I don't know where this paper is from. It's another one of my 6x6 paper pads. I'm sure it's either crepe paper or something fantastic like that. And this is a Recollections tag, some Recollections enamel dots. Very basic, very easy. I used a lot of pop dots to raise some of the stars up. And then I just wanted it to be like a cascading. I don't know which way you want it to go. It's totally up to you. But I thought it looked so cute. And I like this. I thought the asterisks looked like as if it was like a flower in my hair. It was 11:30 at night, remember. And I'm still just as giddy. And I love that it was simple. And then the Heidi Swap. Yeah, look at that. It just adds that pixie dust that the stars were missing. Of course! And then I brought back the yellow that was in the paper here. And it all kind of just worked together. And yeah, tell me that's not such a good idea. Tell me you guys are not so excited to try that out and just to see for yourself how you enjoy it. I tried to bring more white down under here. A white captured one here. I think I need to put a foam dot here. I do. That's what I forgot to do last night. I'll do that once we turn it off. But yeah, what do you think, guys? So exciting. So exciting. Yeah, so layout number 7. 7 layouts. We did well. I think we had so much fun. Capture. I love that one too. Capture. Why? I use that word a lot. Yeah, so that's what I did. That's what I made, my friends. I made so many fun things. And I just love it. I think when you stick to your true self and you allow your expression to come out, no matter how repetitive it is, I know you can see my style. I know you can see my layering style. I know that, you know, it looks like a Monica layout, if that's the way I can say it, or it looks like a Scrap Saturday layout, right? And I do challenge myself, and I want to remind you, I do challenge myself to think outside of the box or to think like the videos that I watch from other people. When I watch them, I like what they do, and then I try it. But and there's no shame in that, right? But you really have to be comfortable with your style, and you really have to be okay with the repetitiveness of what scrapbooking is, because it's that repetitiveness that's going to make you perfect that style that you want or that style that you're looking for. So I hope that that makes sense, but really, honestly, try this technique. Like, I can't tell you. I know you understand what I meant when I first started, and I'm just going to say it one more time. It's like when you're trying to put down a title, but it doesn't really go there because everything else that you've put there, you want the title there, but you settle putting the title somewhere else because, you know, you'll put it down here. You don't really want it down here. You want it like here. You want it to say like capture, right? Capture me going to the grocery store. But you know what I mean. That's funny to me, but you know. I laugh at my own jokes. Yes, I do. But you know what I mean, right? There's sometimes that we settle for something because scrapbooking isn't conducive to what we see, or we see something online and, you know, we wish we had that total placement like other people do. But when I saw this technique, I was like, what? Are you kidding me? This is amazing. And then when I tried it and it worked out, that's the part where I was like, oh my gosh, everybody needs to know this. But to whoever you are that I saw, oh my gosh, thank you so much for making your video that inspired me to do this. And hopefully I've now in turn inspired all of you to do something that you love and create all of these beautiful memories of the best life that you're living for yourself. So huge, huge, big love, 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 all kinds of love. Thank you so much for your beautiful comments. Thank you for watching. I already have a video scheduled to go up Saturday coming up. Yeah, I'm going to try my best. You know, join me. Grab that one photo that speaks to you. Find your favorite piece of paper, even if you only have a tiny little bit left of it. And find your magic. Take care, guys. Thank you so much for watching.